So the 2024 elections may be over, but the war continues. For the first time in decades, there is a contest for the speaker's post. And after no consensus could be reached between the government and the opposition, the stage which is now set for the election of the speakers, that's going to happen at 11 a.m. today. While Om Birla is the NDA nominee, the 8-term Congress MP K. Suresh is a joint India bloc nominee. But given that NDA has already have the majority in the House, victory of Om Birla is almost certain. Both the Congress and the BJP have issued a three-line whip to their respective MPs, asking them to be voting today. Meanwhile, NDA MPs have been also called on breakfast meetings at residences of various senior ministers from their states, where election process would be explained to them exactly what happens today.
Opposition, puri opposition ne kaha hai, humne sab ke sab se baat ki hai. पूरे ऑपोजिशन ने कहा है कि हम स्पीकर को सपोर्ट करेंगे, मगर कन्वेंशन यह है कि डेप्यूटी स्पीकर ऑपोजिशन को मिलना चाहिए। राजनाथ सिंह जी ने कल शाम कहा था कि वो खारगे जी को कॉल रिटर्न करेंगे। अभी तक राजनाथ सिंह जी ने खारगे जी का कॉल रिटर्न नहीं किया है। तो मोदी जी कह रहे हैं कंस्ट्रक्टिव कोऑपरेशन हो, और फिर हमारे नेता को इंसल्ट करा जा रहा है। तो नियत साफ नहीं है।
तो ये जो आदान प्रदान करके ये पद ये पार्टी ले लो, वो पद ये पार्टी, ऐसा स्पीकर और डिप्टी स्पीकर को नहीं कर सकते।
इन द मीन टाइम लेट्स गेट यू अ ब्रेकिंग अपडेट, बिकॉज राइट अहेड विद द लोकसभा स्पीकर्स पोल्स, वी आर गेटिंग टू नो अ बिग इनसाइट स्कूप दैट द ऑपोजिशन इज अनलाइकली when it comes to seeking a division of votes, and if the government gives the deputy speaker's post by 11 a.m. So there is still a conditions apply. Let me go across to Nyamika now. Nyamika, good morning. They are still banking for the deputy speaker's position for Mr. K. Suresh. There is still a rider as far as the India bloc is concerned.
Absolutely, yes. This is the latest information which we are getting from our sources, that the opposition is unlikely to ask for a division of votes during the speaker election. And not just this, in fact, the sources have also indicated that again a condition has been put up by the opposition that if by 11 o'clock the ruling, the treasury benches will agree to give the post of deputy speaker to the opposition, then it might be possible that K. Suresh will take back his nomination from the speaker position. As for that reason, now yesterday we have seen that a meeting was being called by the Congress president and the leader of opposition in Rajya Sabha, Mr. Mallikarjun Kharge, at his residence, in which the floor leaders of the India bloc parties were being present there, and a strategy was being built. And in that particular meeting, it was being told to us by our sources that a discussion had taken place, in which it was being mentioned that all of these leaders are well aware of the fact that they do not have the numerical strength, and that's the only reason why they are not going to ask for the division of votes when there will be voting for the speaker election, as it might be possible that there are some of the people who are not going to support the opposition candidate, which is Mr. K. Suresh. And
then
for that reason,
they don't have the numerical strength, what exactly is the message that Rahul Gandhi and the Congress, Nyamika, wants to give out? I mean, when it comes to saying that they earlier was demanding for the deputy speaker's position, thereafter they drop in K. Suresh's name for the nomination of the speaker's position, aren't they also drawing a lot of criticism when it comes to their own ally from the TMC? What was the whole point in putting forth K. Suresh's nomination?
Well, the message was quite clear, as it was being mentioned by the Congress MP Rahul Gandhi as well, as he has also said that as per the convention, the deputy speaker post is being given to the opposition only. They had waited for that confirmation from the side of the BJP, but no confirmation had come till 11 o'clock, and then only it was a decision which was being taken by the opposition parties that K. Suresh will file his nomination for the speaker post, and that was being done yesterday. And that was the only reason why they were saying that the BJP is not following the parliamentary norms, they are not following the convention, and that's the only reason
but
why they were being compelled
such,
to file
you know,
the
conventions
nomination.
Or traditions that are followed or not, because it's been almost after several decades that such kind of a situation situation that has now arrived, where there is no consensus when it comes to the ruling party and the opposition party, when it comes to the speaker's position in the Lok Sabha. Let's listen in to the reactions that have been coming in. Of course, when it comes to the give and take that has now been cited on part of union minister, saying that this is most unfortunate.
They are not ready to give any assurance. So we are compelled to file a nomination for the post of speaker.
एक पुरानी मानसिकता है कि हम डिक्टेट करेंगे टर्म्स को, उस मानसिकता को फिर से दिखाया जाए कि नहीं, शर्त है कि पहले लोकसभा का उपाध्यक्ष कौन होगा वो पहले तय करें, फिर अध्यक्ष के लिए समर्थन मिलेगा.
Well, as far as today's list of business is also concerned, let's put that out for our viewers, because it is now expected that the Prime Minister today will be moving the motion for Om Birla as the Speaker of the Lok Sabha. The list of business that has been accessed as far as the Prime Minister will also be saying that Om Birla has been chosen to be the Speaker on part of the ruling party's nomination, and the MPs thereafter will be seconding the motion of the Prime Minister. Similarly, India Bloc will also be moving a motion for K. Suresh, and there would be other leaders as well who would be seconding this motion when it comes to supporting the India Bloc's nominee. Now the opposition, which has 243 MPs, we are getting down to the numbers now, because this actually comes down when it comes to the numbers. Now opposition has 243 MPs, while NDA has 293 MPs. So clearly, the majority mark is to get a motion that is to be pushed in the House. The majority mark is at 272, which already now, owing to the ruling party side, the NDA camp, is way beyond that figure. The BJP has, but the Congress doesn't. So still, Congress party decided to field their own veteran MP K. Suresh to contest the Lok Sabha Speaker's elections position. India Bloc clearly doesn't have the numbers, but does the Congress even have the support of its own allies? Let's tell you exactly when it comes to the rationale that Rahul Gandhi has given to fight a losing war. He claims that the Congress party promised to back the ND candidate Om Birla if they get the deputy speaker's position. But the BJP has hit back, saying that there is no such convention that is followed, that the deputy speaker's post must go to the opposition. Let's also talk about right in Karnataka and in Himachal. Now, BJP has been citing reasons, saying that Congress party there, where it is ruling in the state, has already retained both the speaker and the deputy speaker's post. In Telangana, the post remains vacant. In Tamil Nadu as well, in Bengal, the deputy speaker's post is also with the ruling party. So what is the convention that Rahul Gandhi is talking about?
आपका इलेक्शन होना चाहिए, इससे हमारी सहमति है. ये संदेश है दीजिए सैनल चीनी से, जस्टिस स्पीकर से उन्होंने अपोजिशन को देना चाहिए.
कॉन्टैक्ट नहीं किया है, कोई बातचीत नहीं हुआ है, एंड अनफॉर्चुनेटली दिस हैज बीन अ यूनिलैटरल डिसीजन.